paigo ng Diyos. Ang atong tema karon nga hapon igsoon, attaining the fullness of Christ. No, how to attain, how to obtain that fullness of Christ. No? Are we excited? Excited ba tayo igsoon? Hallelujah. So, if you have your Bible with you, let's read this in the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, 13 to 23. Okay, atong dunganan sa pagbasa. Until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Then we will no longer be infants, tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. But saying true words in love, may come to full growth in Him who is the head, even Christ, through whom all the body, being rightly formed and united together by full working of every part, is increased to the building up of itself in love. This I say then and give witness in the Lord, that you are to go no longer in the way of the Gentiles, whose minds are turned to that which has no profit, whose thoughts are dark, to whom the life of God is strange, because they are without knowledge, and their hearts have been made hard. Verse 19, who having no more power of feeling, have given themselves up to evil passions, so as to indulge in every kind of impurity, and they are full of greed. That, however, is not the way of life you learned when you heard about Christ and were taught in Him in accordance with the truth that is in Jesus. You were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self, which being corrupted by its deceitful desires, to be made new in the attitude of your mind. Hallelujah. May God bless the reading of His word. Shall we pray? Our Father, thank you so much, dear Lord, for your word. God, we ask wisdom. Your word, O Lord God, indeed is spirit and it is life. It pierces, Lord God, even to the very core of the soul. Bless each one of us, O Lord God, that it will penetrate, Lord God, to our intellect, to our heart, dear Lord. Mabusog kami, O Diyos, sa diyang amo kining kaunon Ginoo. Praying, Holy Spirit, that I may not speak my own knowledge and ability, but by your dictation, Holy Spirit, talk to us as we listen, as your servant spoke your word. Holy Spirit, fill this place with your presence. I rebuke the spirit of the air. In the name of Jesus, you have no power. Wala kay luna nga imuhang kaunon, imuhang tukbon ang pulong sa Dios. Apan kini Ginoo mag-establisar og maayong butang sulod sa among kasing-kasing. Panalangin ang matag usa o Dios that we will not return home Ginoo nga empty. But Lord, busog kami Ginoo sa espirituhanong panginahanglan. This is all our prayer, Lord. We entrust to you. In the mighty name of Jesus, everybody say, Amen and Amen. Praise the Lord. So magsugod tayo son about the giftings of the church. No? God's best gift are people who help us to become like Jesus. No? In our journey, on our journey sa atong kinabuhi, adunay mga tao nga atong nakauban, atong namingle, no? And in the Bible, there are five offices of workers, the prophet, the apostles, the prophet, until to the pastors. Each of them naka-contribute nato kung unsay ato ang becoming. No? Sa message sa kanta nako ganina, it's our lifestyle as a believer, as a Christian, as a believer of Christ, mauna atong becoming, ingana ka paunsa, nga imuhang gisimba, gitahod ang Diyos sa matag-adlaw, sa matag-gutlo sa imong kinabuhi. imong pasidunggan ang Dios, imong i-acknowledge ang Lord. How he paved your way to become holy. This is our becoming. Amen. Ang atong kinabuhi is meaningful in Christ. Walay Kristohanon nga miingon, "Why, pulos akong kinabuhi?" Walay meaning akong kinabuhi. Empty ang akong kinabuhi. Murag nag-declare ni mo nga wala kay Ginoo. But life in the Lord is our becoming. Becoming holy. And we are being made into the image of Jesus Christ. From the beginning, di ba? We are created in His own likeness. We are predestined to do good. All our experiences are for our perfection. Agree? Tanan natong experience is para sa, para mahimo tang maayo, maging better every day. Wala experience nato nga naga drag nato to down. Naga diminish nato. Like sa mga tinanawan sa mga tao sa kinabuhi ni Apostle Paul. Though others may say that I am losing, ingon siya, ingon ni Apostle Paul, but in my inside, I am gaining. And this is our prayer. Nang matag-usa nato, we are gaining, dili ta lugi sa kinabuhi kung naa si Kristo. Amen? Walay lugi, nadagdagan ang ato ang growth. It is the will of God that we will increase sa atong knowledge about godly things, about the heavenly things. Atong punon ang atong hunahuna sa Diyos nun nga panghunahuna. Mga positibo. Therefore, the greatest gift we can be given, the greatest gift we can be given is someone who help us to become the person that God designed us to be. Amen? Halimbawa ikaw, nagpagamit ka sa Ginoo, katong imuhang gisiran, katong imuhang giimpluwensyahan, gusto nimo mahimong pareho nimo. Amen? Gusto nato, mapareho nato. Kaya naman tayo Jesus. Or atong i-point kanunay kay Jesus. Because He is the only one who is perfect. Dili ta perpekto. Natay mga tendencies. But salamat sa Ginoo, if we have Christ, we are saved from that power nga makahimo patag dili maayo kay makontrol naman nato. Tay naa may Holy Spirit nga na-dictate nato. No? The primary function of those people who is contributing sa ato ang influence, sa ato ang knowledge of the Lord is to assist us on our journey towards Jesus. So our life is about our journey towards Christ. Reaching, attaining, no? Attaining to the fullness of Christ in our lives. Yes, because from the very beginning, we were created in the exact fullness of the image of God, into perfection. But, kahit ba mo sa problema, but sin entered, distorted, nag-deform, nag-degrade, until to the level nga nahimo tang murag basahan, nahimong trapo, nahimong hugaw sa atong pananaw. But thank be to God, Christ came, si Jesus gipadala sa Ginoo, aron maghatag og pamaagi nato to go back to the heights again from where we came. And before ascending up on high, no, si Jesus, before siya nisaka dito sa langit, He have gifts to men, to His church, to the body of Christ, to help us attain, to help us attain, but pasabot, in the process, aron maproseso ka into perfection. Because we are being perfected by God day by day by day. Amen? Diha mo gawas ginatawag that Jesus is our sanctifier. Ginasanctify ta niya daily. No? In the process until we reach to the fullness of Christ. Completeness, fullness. So naay ginatawag nga proseso. What will happen in the process No? Unsabay mahitabo in the process nga kita naga kinabuhi sa matag adlaw with the Lord. Daghang mga ups and downs. But we are hopeful. We are peaceful. Jesus is the peace. He said, I will give you peace that the world cannot give. I will give you peace that the world never give. In the world, you have many trouble, but lo and behold, I already overcome the world. This is the promise of the Lord. Nga dili ta niya biyaan. So ibig sabihin, so in the process, we are moving on to level after another. No? The growth in Christ. Adun natay pagtubo niya ni Kristo, but how? Paano? Paul gives us the answer to this question by describing or explaining Christian stages of level of attainment in Christ. Atong gibasa kaganina. But pasabot igsoon, Christianity offers advancement in life. Wow. So kung naata sa belief nga atong gibarugan, naghatag nato og advancement. No naatay opportunity aron mo uswag. Amen. Increase. There's no way to go down, but to be up. Always tamag increase. Amen. Kindly say to your neighbor, we shall increase. No? You will be blessed. Mo increase na. Walay panahon sa pagka ilalum, pagka discourage. No? It is the ascending life, if we have Christ. Di ta malipay, anak? Are we not happy that we have that advancement, that we have that attainment in Christ by the process that we have the ascending life from sinners being saved by grace, of course. No, this is the first level. Nahimutang mga bata, mahimutang infant, kaganina, no? Until we all reach the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God and becoming mature. So sa wala pa ta na mature, nahimutang immature. Niagita ana. Daghan kaig mga attitude of immaturity. Dali mangluod, matog simbahan, kaduha ang atras, isa ang abante, matog ko dili, makakitag dagom, muulan na, ni ulan. Di ta manimba kay ni ulan na. Naguna-una ba? Muna'y advance sa pagka-negative. Nganong dili na to pilion ang pag-decide nga dili pa ni mo ulan. Dili ta maabtag ulan. Positive. Amen? We have that ascending life. No, from sinner saved by the grace of God. That is the level of babes. Then to being a child of God. From infant. Nahimukang batanon o kanabang bayong-bayong young men, then nahimutang children of God, sons and daughters, and then nahimutang servant of God, sulugoon sa Dios, o nahimutang anak sa Ginoo, o namuhat sa ministry. No? Doing discipleship, dapat mo abuta diha. Nga mo advance ta, makita ni mong kaugalingon that you are attaining in the maturity kung namuhat ka, naghimo ka disciple, nag-share ka og gospel, mo nang attainment nga nakumpleto ni mo ang level nga giingon ni Apostle Paul. Hello. Ina mong katapad nana kay nasiran. How far na ba ang imuhang journey kay Lord? 5 minutes, we can have all the pulpit nga atong i-share ang gospel. Amen? Are we riding diha sa Acts 6 nga journey until we reach, no, the multiplication of the gospel? Usa ta maingon nga, relax ako. But until wa tay nasiran, no? Wala ka sa position nga mo relax. dapat mo ascend ka pa kung asa ko kutob. Amen? Number one is the level of advancement. Because there are many levels. Pag-abot na to sa ascending life, sa ato ang growth, in the process of perfection. The level of advancement. In verse 14, okay, kindly show that verse 14. Then we will no longer be infants. Dili kuno kita magpabiling bata. No longer children, tossed to and fro and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men in craftiness after the wills of error. Dili kuno kita ing ana. Dili ta diha padong. In British Bible version, so that we may be no longer children, sent this way and that, torn about by every wind of teaching, by the twisting and tricks of men, by the deceit of error. The level of advancement, so na akong gibutangan og duha ka division. Number one, stage of stability, atong i-create. Nahimong stabilize ang imuhang foundation. Naakay deepness of your faith, diha kay Lord. No? No longer be infants. Mone ato ang target. Mone ato ang paningkamutan nga mo exceed ta din ha, nga dili ta magpabiling bata. Stage of stability, tossed to and fro in verse 14. Tossed to and fro, kana bitong murag unsay ingon din ha? Tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind. Kana makita nimo sa dito, makita na po nimo siya ugma, tao-tao din na po makitaan. Nya kung ikaw kung nagtanaw kag tao, nagkatag ang imong pananaw. Hello! Na-experience ninyo na, nga natin mga kaigsuunan ngayong ana, na-experience na ko na before, na ako'y gina-look up. But igsuon, it is part of your growth as a believer. Amen? Nga dili ta magpabilin sa ato ang kahibalo. Na bata ka pa, kanang nagkamang gani, di pa kahibaw mo tindog. So ang ato ang focus is ma-establish lang ato ang tiil na makalakaw ta. Before na ay mag-assist na to. But sa dihang na nakabato na pila ka years, kabalo na ka mo tindog, kabalo na ka mo lakaw, until such time na wala na mo guide ni mo, buot-buot na ka og para og sakyanan. Kung asa ka paad to. God's purpose for giving us men and women in the ministry office so that they may have the part of stabilizing or adding stability in your life through their ministry. No, sa ato ang experience. Adunay mga tao nga atong nasugata na kauban. Sila part sa imuhang pagtubo. Part sa imuhang growth. No? But many Christians, so they are like riding a swing. Kasi nakasakay na og swing. O sa aming kahunong na, kaya nalipong na ko. Na mo decide ka di sa atamo simba, kay murag nalurong naman ko, sige libot-libot. Asa mangyuda. Kay infant, no, sa stage, no? Having motion of forward and backward. High and low, yet without an inch of developing a progress. But pasabot kung naga-ascend ka, naga-descend ka, naga-forward, naga-backward, dili ko na ta makagain of an inch of progress. Di ba na ipanultihon na statement that a rolling stone gathers no moss. Kung ikaw kuno bato, nagsigig ligid-ligid, dili, wala kuno'y sana ibisayaan ng moss. Lumot! Pasensya naman sa akong Bisaya, kasang laluma. Lumot, dili kuno ka matubkan og lumot, kay sige man ka roll. Agree? Hello? Amen. So God wants us to grow and attain the levels of Christ's stature. Christ's stature, ang ato ang target. We must move forward. We must be a type of people that are progressing in all levels of life. Nag-progress ta. And it starts with our own decision making. So magsugod yun sa atong decision. A stable decision. Dili basta-basta decision lang, but a stable decision. Hindi urong-sulong. Orong sulong Christianity. Ingna ko na ibang neighbor, you are no longer babe, but a child. No? Grow up. We must grow up. We must have the advancement in attitude. Ang ato kunong attitude is advance. Hindi ka matampuhin, hindi ka na matampuhin. Muraglain man atong isulti sa atong katapat nung ano man, kanang matampuhin ba ko? Sanang maludanon. Dili na ka ludanon. Hindi ka na maramdamin. Pareho ra na, ludanon gihapon na. Hindi ka na mainitin. Init og ulo. Hallelujah. Ikaduha nga division igsoon, stage of stability and in the stage of solidity. Imagine na apat sa level of advancement. We have two categories, the stage of stability and the stage of solidity. Solidity kanang mahimo na kang gahi. Amen. Gahi agyud nimo oy. Di matinag. And carried about by every wind of doctrine, no? And blown here and there by every wind of teaching, and by the cunning and the craftiness of people in their deceitful scheme. Dapat magiging ano ta, kanang solid kung unsay atong gituhuan. We must be firm and tough with our knowledge and experience with God. No? Akong huna-huna, ang primary reason why Christians are carried away with every doctrine is because usahay na alang, ato lang gibutang sa ato ang huna-huna, sa atong head. No? Sa ato ang head, sa ato ang ulo, but devoid of experiencing God. No? Napungan ang atong pag-experyensya kung unsa ang Ginoo. Like our God is our provider. Adunay mga sitwasyon sa imong kinabuhi nga nahimo si God, nga hinahimo ni mong provider. So sometimes igsoon ang atong growth is experiential. Amen. Agree? Experiential. Nagtubo ang imuhang faith that God reveals to you as your provider. That God reveals to you as your shepherd. Siya imong magbalantay. Siya atong magbalantay. I would like to challenge you, no? That you have to really desire of knowing God by experience. Experience His person. Atong experience ang iyang pagkatawhanon. God has His emotion. Nahimo sang tao pareho nato. That's why He can relate sa atong emotion. He can relate why our tears fall. He can relate sa dihang di na ka magtingog-tingog. Wala namin nagtingog-tingog akong anak na ko. Ano po siya ni sangpit na ko. God can relate us. No? Experience His presence. Atong experience ang presensya sa Dios. During sa ato ang worship, sa atong praise, i-experience igsoon ang presensya sa Dios nga imong mabati. Because God reveals His presence gikan dinhi sa altar down diha sa ato sa lingkuranan. I-feel nimo igsoon. That's why kanang kanta nga akong ginakanta kanunay, maunay akong kanta sa akong kinabuhi. Diha sa presensya sa Dios na ay matuod nga kagawasan. There is true freedom. There is fullness of joy. Kung ma-experience nimo ang presence ni Lord, makapasalamat ka. Makadeklarar kag mga butang. Nga imong gi-acknowledge ang Dios. We must experience His Word. Ang iyang pulong. Aduna ba tay Word ni Lord? Naa ba tay balon sa dihang mo gawas ka sa imuhang balay? Do you have the Word of the Lord? The Bible says, bind it around your neck. Meditate it day and night. Where is the Word? Are we experiencing God's Word? This is the Word of God for me today. usa na igsuon sa ato ang solidity, level of solidity, masolidize na to kung kinsa si Lord sa atong kinabuhi. We must experience God by His Word. We must experience God pinaagi siyang gugma, siyang love. Pwede na ito ma-assess atong kaugalingon, Lord, nganong dili madyod ko maluoy? Nganong kulang madyod akong love? Iksoon pangayo ah. Because God commanded us to be radical, to love the unlovable. Kung unsa gani dili ang ay higugmaon, mo na gisugo sa Ginoo nga higugmaan na siya. Amen? Kanunay na ito na mabati ni Pastor Dave, love your enemies. Treat them well. Let them eat. Let them drink. So kung naamoy kaaway, paghimog milagro, pakauna siya. Amen? We must experience God's love. Kaya kung na-experience nimo ang gugma sa Dios, imo sad ma-share. Because it is simply, you cannot give what you don't have. Kung wala nimo na-experience ang love ni Lord, paano ka gipasaylo, paano ka gikaluyan, dili sad nimo ma-share sa uban ang love. That's why we must experience love. We must experience Christ's provision. Naka-experience ba mo nga gi-provide ni Lord ang mga butang nga inyohang gikinahanglan? Amen? Are we experiencing that attribute of God that He is our great provider? Na-experience na ko na igsoon. No? During that time nga naami sa airport, kaya gihold me sa embassy. Gipangayuan mig $130,000 in a foreign land. Nobody could understand English. But praise the Lord, so on. I prayed in the spirit, Lord, ikaw ang nagpadala na mo din, please, save us. Naitaw, igsoon, miduol na ako. Please, say to this person, no? He is a great help for you. Kabalo mo unsay gipanguta na sa tao nako, I need $130,000. What is your problem? Nya likas na tong Pilipino mag flowering words pa ta. Sir, inga ni manggod ang among agency inga ni na delay ang amo ang nagchange ang aircraft. So no, what is your problem? Ang atong pagka Pilipino mutong ano, di man ta mo ingon dayog I love you? Di ba, maingon pa matag kanindot sa imong buhok, kagwapos imong panit, no? Hello, mga gentlemen, di ta mo ingon-ingon dayog I love you, daghan kita flowering words, kay masagpaan tag priskura kayta. What is your problem? Sir, $130,000, sabay tulo sa luwa sa, come on, let's pay. Wow, I'm crying inside. Tinuod ang pulong sa Dios that I am your very present help in time of trouble. Because you love me, I will rescue you, says the Lord. I will help you. Na-experience na ako na igsoon. Kinsa may mubayad ni mo? First time ni mo mamit na ang tao. My experience contributed to my faith to the Lord that He is my great provider. Amen? Are we willing to experience God, that He is our great provider? Experience God, that He is our healer. Yes. Hallelujah. Siya ang atong mananambal. Experience God sa iyang mga milagro. Signs and wonders, protection, grace, and supernaturals. We must experience God. Igsoon kung may experience nimo ang pagkadako sa Dios, mahimo kang active, makadungog kag kanta nga pang-Ginoo, murag magkitiw ang imuhang dughan sa kalipay. Kayang Ginoo nato gamhanan, kay ang Ginoo nato balaan, kay ang Ginoo nato tag-iya sa tanan. Amen. Kay ang Ginoo nato malauman, kay ang Ginoo nato kasaligan. Kasaligan ba ang Dios? So kung naa kay bill, kataw ilang na kay tagbuon ra sa Ginoo imong panginahanglan. Amen. Katuka ang langit. Hallelujah. Go to the altar, kneel down before the Lord. Knock the heavens. Unsa ingon sa Lord? Call unto me and I will answer thee and show you great things that thou knowest not. Ipakita nako ninyo ang akong gahom. You see, experiencing God will solidify your understanding with God. Ang ato kunong experience sa Dios mag-solidify sa atong pagtuo diha sa Dios. Why do you need to accept this kind of ministry? Nganong i-accept nato kaning kind nga pagtuo nga atong i-experience ang Ginoo? Because igsoon ang Dios nato naghatag kanato og level of advancement nga kinabuhi, no? The advancement of life. Ikatulo igsoon, status of strength, status of stability, status of solidity, and the status of strength, no? Tanawa ang atong verse nga atong gibasa. By the slay of men in craftiness, God wants us to reach our full potential in Christ. And that is the status of His strength. Kung unsa atong posible nga mabuhat nato, we have the potential of declaring things to positive. Whatever we accomplish, whatever we establish, it will accomplish. Amen? Kung unsa imong gideclare na sa libro ni Job, whatever you establish in your mouth, it will accomplish. It will come to pass. That is the power of the mouth, the power of declaration. The real strength of a man is measured by how he maintains and overcomes the skills and the cunningness of an opponent. No? Ang tinuod daw nato nga kusog is how to overcome sa strength sa ato ang kalaban. Unsa na to pag-overcome? We must know sa ilang action, sa ilang strategy, sa ilang position. Kay warfare man, no? Diha masukod na ito ang kusog, kay naamantay Dios. The real battle is not the physical but on the mind. Ang tinuod nga pakigira, dili kuno sa physical, but sa ato ang mind, sa huna-huna. That is why the enemy will always attack the mind, the will of a man. Kanunay mo atake ang yawa sa atong huna-huna. Dapat ang ato ang sensory thing diritso kanunay sa altar sa Dios. Amen? Kanunay nato ipunting diha sa Ginoo. Look at the way Satan deals with Jesus sa dihang gitem si Jesus. At the early stage of his ministry, did he not fought with guns and ammunition, not with a sword sa dihang gitem si Jesus? Not with the spears, not with a piece of fury, but words, cunning and crafty words. Diba? Si Satan nagamit pa og verse. No? And I will give you the kingdoms of the world. And Jesus dealt with him through the strength of his mind. Paano ni Jesus gi-defend? Paano ni Jesus gibarugan ang temptation? Ang cunning words ni Satan. Jesus fought it with his mind, with the strength of his mind. No, you see, there are Christians who are easily swayed, derailed, shattered by the immaturity of words and nasty words of unbelievers. No, tanaw na to, unbelievers, mutuo pa ta usahay, no? Namingon nga, ipakuan na, ipa-check up na dito sa kuan, dito sa turil. Kaya na ay kuan dito. Christian na ha, dugay na. Pero matuo rag hapon. Pero pag-abot dito, kaya nakita man niya sa iyang vision nga ang katong gipakita dito, naisungay. So nag-reveal ang Lord sa iya nga fake tong God dito, ang iyang power, ang powerful si Jesus na gihapon ni Atras sa pastor. Tinuod yun na si Jesus lang yun ang powerful, dili itong naadito. Ang pangutana nga nung nag-step in, nag-step out man kasi mong balay padung dito, where is your faith? Again, sa atong verse nga gibasa, many Christians were trapped by the religious words nowadays. The Bible says, no? No courses today. Wala na yung ingon nga, wala na kuan karon, wala na pag courses, wala na tunglo. Wala na pangilat. But naara gihapon na, igsoon. Naara gihapon na. Ikaupat igsoon, stand of steadiness. Stand of steadiness. No? Ikatulo na itong learning is a status of strength, then the stand of steadiness after the wiles of error. No? People in their deceitful scheming. The best way to defeat error and all its schemes of the devil, deceitful schemes, faulty tricks, is to stand. Barug igsoon, stand up. Be steadfast. Diba? In Corinthians 15:58. Therefore, my dear brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, stand firm, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that our labor is not in vain. Baruch, stand up, stand of steadiness. Usana sa mga parts sa level of advancement, gagihatag ni Lord nato. Be watchful, stand firm in the faith. Act like men. Numuak ka nga hamtong. Be strong. 1 Corinthians 16, verse 13. For freedom Christ has set us free, stand firm therefore, and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery. Gitagaan tag kagawasan sa Dios, aron mahimo kang gawas nun. Amen? Dili kuno ka ginapos. To a yoke of slavery. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand in the evil days. Ephesians 6:13-14. And having done all, stand firm. Kaduha gibalik igsoon. Twice. Okay? Therefore, put on the full. Okay? 6:13. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, to stand. Amen? Barug igsoon. Tindog. Attaining the fullness of Christ is to stand with steadiness. Aron ma-attain nimo ang fullness of Christ. The level of advancement. Stand up. Be firm. No longer children. Means we are advanced. Means we move from children to adolescent to adulthood. Amen? Level of advancement. The factors, my dear brethren, is steady. Steady, fixed, constantly. Wow. Perpetual. Makanunayon. Amen? Makanunayon ang imuhang pagbarug. Walay landong sa pagkabugnaw. Walay landong sa pagka-discourage. Makaplagan ka sa Dios na maisugon na nangalagad sa Dios. Ikaduha igsoon, the level of acknowledgement. Makita nato sa verse 15-16. No, level of acknowledgement. In Ephesians chapter 4, 15-16. Recognition, acceptance, admission, confession, appreciation, tribute, we all need that thing. Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will grow to become in every respect the mature body of Him who is the head, that is Christ. That is Christ. When there is growth in Christ, where there is that level of maturity, when the body of Christ reaches the level of progressiveness, development, reliability, there is acceptance. Amen? Kung ma-attain na to ang level of acknowledgement, take note, sa maturity atong gihisgutan. Kung maabot na ka nga, mature ka na, di ba madinawaton ka na, kung i-correct ka, na kay acceptance. Kay subjective pa man ta. No? We have that acceptance. We have that appreciation. Kabalo ka mo appreciate. Tungod kay puno ang imuhang kasing-kasing sa mga maayong butang. Kabalo ka mo appreciate. Kabalo ka mo recognize sa mga maayong nabuhat sa imong isig katao. We begin to make compliments. Amen? So kahibaw tatanan ana, no? Labi na nakaagitag DFS, kahibaw ta mo hatag og appreciation. Kahibaw ta mo himo og affirmation. We are rich in that teaching igsoon. Level of acknowledgement is saying, ingon din ha, speaking. Everybody say speaking. I-speak na to, i-declare na to, saying the true words, the authentic words from our heart. Hello. Ang ato bang mga pulong gikan sa kasing-kasing, authentic, kabalo mo, mahibaw, mo-convict ba yan atong ka-istorya kung ang atong pagsulti, dili tininood, dili gikan din he. No? Kami sa 700 Club, kung motubag mig telephone nga kanabitaw sa kakapoy, labi nag night shift, na ay magpa-pray over na mo, amo kay nuna i-embrace ang amo ang system. Nga kinahanglan ang amo ang tingog, ang among itubag sa among mga caller, dili mechanical. Kay naman mig i-memorize ng mga spiel. Dili mechanical. Kay mabalaan na sa imuhang ka-istorya na dili ka from the heart nakikistorya niya, bundakan kag telephone. Nya we capture the moment na go na for salvation. So dili na to sayangan ang panahon. We must speak up in truth. Amen? Ingon din na, speaking the truth in love. Diha sa gugma. Sa akong version, saying, but saying true words in love may come to full growth in Him. Sa pagsulti nimo sa tininuod authentic nga words, ang imuhang ang recipient mutubo sa iyang gugma sa Dios. Ang recipient, no, ang receiver may come to full growth in Him who is the head, even Christ. Ingon din na sa verse, no? Through whom all the body being rightly formed and united together by the full working of every part. Adunay part ang batang usa. No? Now look at the words Paul used to allow us to see how we attain the fullness of Christ. We must enter the level of acknowledging one another. Ikaduhang level, di ba? Una-una, level of advancement, the level of acknowledgement. No? By acknowledging one another, by seeing, being, working. Wow. Puro action. Seeing, speaking, working, being, building. So there is an edification between one another sa mga magtotoo. No? Positive confession, but saying true words in love. We begin to say words of appreciation, words of love, words of honoring, words of confidence, constructive words, affirmative words, confirming words, and assuring words. You see, all of these things must we attain, and so on.
aron ma-attain na to ang fullness of Christ. Every words that we will speak, say to one another, we will attain easily and quickly the stature of Christ. No? Mahimo kitang pareho ni Kristo. The way Christ spoke. The Bible says that when we speak positive words. Now, then he exhorts a level of acknowledgement, there is personal commitment. Being rightly formed and united together. Rightly formed. But pasabot igsoon, the exact form. United together. There is a need of personal commitment. Saying positive confession or statement are indeed wonderful. It is a personal commitment. The proverb says, gracious words or pleasant words are like honeycomb, sweetness to the soul and health to the body. Ang maayong pulong. Diba there are words nga makakrush out sa spirit? Na-notice ninyo? Na naisinultihan nga, imbis kay lami imong kaon, di nalang kamukaon. Kay natukan ka. Okay, next is personal construction. Personal contribution. Personal contribution. Hallelujah. Each of us must build up the body of Christ. Each of us must build up as a church. It is our responsibility to build up one another, to create one another, to fashion, to form according to the makeup of Christ. Each of us must be responsible to lift the level of our own Christian lives and to lift the level of corporate life as a church, locally and then globally. Amen. So, this is the word of the Lord that reminding us that we must attain His fullness in our daily journey in the Lord, in our daily walk diha sa Ginoo. Hinumdumi igsoon ang pulong sa Dios in Ephesians chapter 4 that we must level up. We must attain the maturity as a believer. Being strong, be firm in our decision making. Sa atong belief, corporately as a church, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Shall we pray? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God, it is our prayer, Lord, in attaining, O Lord God, of your fullness, let us be, O Lord God, be one of those hearts, Lord, nga nag-desire, O God, to grow into maturity, to level up, O God, in that advancement in life, in that level, O Lord God, of acknowledgement, to that level, Lord God, to create, to form our stability, our solidity in you, our steadfastness in you. Thank you, Jesus, for your word. Continue to bless each one of us, O Lord God, in your grace, in your peace. This we ask, Lord, this we pray, O God, in the name of Jesus. Everybody say, amen and amen.